Welcome to the Stan Sheriff Center, a special evening tonight. Hawaii versus UCLA, always an electric vibe here at the Stan Sheriff Center. And the Hawaiian Tel FCU starting lineup scrolling at the bottom of your screen. So many Hawaii connections on the UCLA coaching staff. Mike Seeley, former associate coach, next to that man, Dave Shoji, in his 40th season as head coach for Hawaii. Just to name a few, UCLA serving to start the match. Carly Grossen sends it into the net, so Hawaii breaks the ice first. On the second night of the 2014 Outrigger Resorts Volleyball Challenge, it will be Taylor Higgins back to serve. Tops on the team with 15 service aces. She is the setter, and she slaps it into play. A good serve, scrambled by UCLA. Olga Stronzoli two-hands it over, but McGill turns it back. So Olivia McGill, who has been the standard of excellence and consistency for Hawaii in the early goings of this season, getting the Rainbow Wahine up too.
A lot of people are in awe of her attacking, but how about her blocking? She's been really special at the net, reading the other team's hitters.
Came into this match leading the team with 41 blocks. No one blocking that one, though, off of the palm of Olga Stronzoli, a 6'1 freshman from Greece. Second on the team with 3.1 kills per set. Two left-handed bombers along that front line for UCLA in Stronzoli and Costello. But Olivia McGill, she packs a punch as well. And she gets another point for Hawaii. Good start for Olivia McGill.
I expected that Mike Seeley might put two blockers up on her, but instead he only had one. Not quite enough.
Time on Olevao with a good serve, overpass. McGill couldn't put it down. It'll be a high bump set to Stronzoli, hits it into the net. Manu Olevao, who had a career-high 6 aces last night versus Utah State. And Hawaii able to benefit from another tough serve.
Yeah, and she actually half hit that one. I think she's going to work her way into her power serves. May see a little harder one right here.
Dave Shoji saying this is an area Hawaii will have to play well in. They're going to have to serve tough. Karsta Lowe off the block. Ginger Long scrambles. Higgins goes outside to Kalei Greeley. Blocked and roofed. That is a big front line there for UCLA. It was Lowe at 6'4", and Claire Felix at 6'6".
They've grown big in Westwood, Cadell, I'm telling you. This is a large UCLA team.
And here is Lowe. Tops in the nation in kills per set. Near 7 kills per set. Greeley can't put it down. Diving save Taylor Formico. Now Stronzoli over the block, and she finds the end line. And just like that, the Bruins back within a point.
Olga's got her parents watching from Greece right now as we speak. I hope they're enjoying it on their computer wherever they are. Probably in the big, large city of a million people, Thessaloniki.
Lowe sends it into the net. Going Hawaii. And it will be Sarah Mendoza, senior assistant team captain, and libero back to serve for Hawaii. Top 25 matchup, number 22 Hawaii versus number 25 UCLA. Step out goes to Felix. High hands right there is Manu Olevao. Outside Greeley. The block hadn't formed yet, and Greeley made it happen.
Nice set by Taylor Higgins. Just firing out there nice and fast. UCLA block split right there. You see the seam? You see the hole? Greeley found it too.
The freshman, third on the team with 2.4 kills per set. Stronzoli again, good touch up front. It'll be a bump set to Greeley. Tight to the net, though, she slaps it over. Advantage now for the Bruins. And catching the team off guard was Julie Consani, a 5'11 senior. Did not enter the year as the expected starter, but played 3 seasons at Cal State Fullerton, where she finished 6th all-time in career assists. So playing for the would-be starter, Megan Moinoa, who is injured, also a senior. And Consani's played well.
She's really stepped up.
And there is an ace from Olga Stronzoli. UCLA went without an ace last night against San Francisco, but able to get one there.
Very unusual because UCLA out-aces their opponents by about 2-1. Stronzoli known for her serving, by the way. One of the things that drew Mike Seeley to her as a player.
Greeley. That's two-handed in the air by Lowe. Stronzoli bumps, sets Lowe. Left-handed swing, diving save Higgins. Adolfo sets up long against the double block, and she hits it wide. No touch up front. And we draw even here in the first set, six serving six. Yeah, that serve by Olga Stronzoli, Chris. The high toss up into the rafters, and it comes smoking out of the pond.
And did you see where Carson Lowe made her attack in the middle of that rally? From about the 15-foot line, forced Hawaii into a bad pass.
Another tough serve, overpass. Felix couldn't put it down, Long was there. Now Greeley. Dug up in the back row by Stronzoli. Chased down by Lowe. Free opportunity for Hawaii, but it goes wide. Bumped over wide by Riley Bushler, a 6'1 freshman from Del Mar, California.
Now, into the game for UCLA comes another Hawaiian connection, Rachel Inoue. Savannah Kahakai comes in as well, but Inoue, an interesting story. She played in Puno, won the state championship, said that was her biggest athletic thrill, played for Coach Peter Balding, and now she's got some nice back row duty here for the Bruins.
Good serve by Kahakai, results in the overpass. Higgins finds the floor on the second touch.
Well, Taylor Higgins does not dump the ball a lot, but when she does, it seems to be at the right time and the right place.
Yeah, Higgins, a former teammate of the aforementioned Rachel Inoue at Punahou. We got a few of them on these two rosters. Felix on the step out.
Taimanu Olivao, another teammate.
There you go. Punahou alums wide in this match. But check out Felix at 6'6".
Adolfo almost closed that block. Tough to get out there. The Bruins tend to set the ball quickly. Might have some Mike Seeley trade. He loves to get the ball fast out to the pins.
Higgins goes out to Greeley. Finds the deep corner. That is kill number three here on seven early swings for Kalei Greeley.
By the time Greeley, I think, went over the smallest blocker she could find, that's Kasani at 5'11". The rest of the Bruins in the front row all seem to be 6'1 or bigger.
Saw her stat line last night against Utah State. 9 kills and a career-high 11 digs. Overpass by Bushler, and Kalei Dolfo is able to place it down to the Terraflex. Good sign for Adolfo, who was held to just 1 kill on 7 swings last night against the Aggies, Chris.
A very un-Adolfo-like night, to be sure. Her offense needs to pick up, hit only 150 last night, averaging only 1.35 kills per set. She's got to bring that up.
Bushler gets the set on the outside and makes it count past the diving Mendoza.
I love the way Bushler played last night. I also watched her play against that Illinois match. And there's her father right there. 3 NBA titles to his name.
That's right.
Played for the Chicago Bulls.
Judd Bushler, former volleyball All-American at Arizona, and then a 12-year NBA career. Played next to the great Michael Jordan. Step out, Adolfo. Dug up nicely in the back row by Inoue. Now Bushler, cross court right there, is Kahakai. Greeley from the back row. The touch up front, and UCLA keeps it alive. Here's Lowe. Gets up so high and such a powerful swing.
Well, you see everybody else hit the ball in that rally, and you see some nice digs, and all of a sudden, Karsten Lowe hits the ball. It's a different sound. It's a different speed. It's more difficult to dig. That's why she's the most prolific attacker in the United States right now.
Consani with the serve for UCLA. Step out, Adolfo. Good to see this start from the senior captain.
Much quicker move. Nice set by Taylor Higgins to the outside. Flicked it out there very quickly behind her head. Adolfo caught the seam, a little hole in the block.
She rotates out. McGill rotates in, and Claire Marie Anderson, I know what you're going to say.
I'm not going to say it.
Another Punahou alum. Right side, here's Bushler. High touch, it hit the scoreboard. Played by Manu Olevao. Back row set to Greeley. Scramble by the Bruins. Nicely done. Free opportunity for Hawaii. Higgins, high and away. Manu Olevao. It's roofed. That one caught the far sideline. Bushler got the gist of it.
Yeah, I think she got most of it. That was a terrific block away from Sandy. Look at that, all by herself out there. Turns that right hand into the court and just drives it down. Great play.
Back to serve for UCLA, Carly Drolson. 5'6 junior, also from Del Mar, just like Riley Bushler. Led the Bruins last year with 3.5 digs per set. Had 6 20-dig matches, also a consistent server. Floats it over, Greeley there. Higgins, tight to the net, set up McGill, missed the court. And it looked like there was some contact with the Higgins set there from the UCLA side of the net.
Wayne Lee says no, the ball is 50-50. Anybody can attack it. Either team can do it. And there he saw Nightingale go up and touch it first.
So 11 serving 11. McGill denied in the middle by Zoe Nightingale. Led the Bruins in blocks the last two seasons.
She also played in that 2011 National Championship game against Illinois. One of two players in this team that were there for that National Championship game.
First lead of this opening set for UCLA. Greeley with the pass, middle set. McGill, the dink, and it falls to the floor.
Second kill for McGill. I remember what Ryan Tsuji said last night in the postgame show. He said, you know, Mike Seeley is going to know what to do with his defense on Olivia McGill. He's been playing against her and scouting her for 2 years. He's got film glory, maybe the best film watcher in the country.
Step out goes to Nightingale. That was quick. A lightning bolt off of the palm of Nightingale.
Zoe Nightingale gets up quickly, hits it just like Calandolfo did a little while ago. It's almost like mirror images of each other.
So 13 serving 12. Manuel Leval couldn't quite control that pass. And it'll be a free opportunity for UCLA. The set high and away. Stronzoli, the dink, just beyond the outstretched reach of Taylor Higgins. Olga Stronzoli, an interesting story, the way she matriculated to UCLA, Chris.
Yes, her dad is actually my son Spencer's coach in Greece, playing professionally. And he came up to, one visit over there a couple years ago, and he said to me, you know, I got my daughters pretty good. So Spencer immediately got a hold of Dave Shoji and said, Dave, I got this girl in Greece, it's pretty good. I thought she was a great player as well. Until we'll finish the story after the break.
UCLA up three in the first. Take a look at the Kaiser Permanente keys to the match, Chris.
The UCLA, they got six-footers everywhere, especially in their front row. They average two blocks per set. UH hitters, beware, you better hit high. For Hawaii, get two up on Carson Lowe all the time and bring your stepladder while you're at it, because she hits high and over a lot of blocks.
UCLA hitting 353 to start this match. Also four team blocks. Hawaii 095. It'll get better off of that time on Ole Vau kill and one team block. Finish up on Stronzoli.
Oh, so Stronzoli said, her father said, you know, I don't think I can let her go to Hawaii. It's exactly halfway around the world. Too far for me. But we can go to the West Coast.
And that's how she ended up at UCLA.
Exactly.
Good scramble by the Bruins here. Here's Stronzoli. And it will be a back row attacker call against UCLA, so Hawaii gets the point. Look at Mike Seeley in his fifth season. Six victories away from reaching the 100 win mark.
Master tactician, second year of coaching in the NC2A as a head coach, wins the NC2A championship. Oh, my goodness.
My word.
Did I tell you she hits at a different speed?
That was a detonation from Karsten Lowe.
I felt it over here. Oh my goodness gracious. No, there might as well have been no block up at all, though I know that Greeley was trying to get to the outside.
McGill got blocked, punched it up in the air. Higgins has to two-hand it over. Big advantage for the Bruins here. High and away, Stronzoli took something off. Diving save Mendoza. Greeley gets a chance. Off the block. Bump set goes to Stronzoli. Mendoza there again for Hawaii. Higgins chases down the second touch. Here's Greeley. Puts it to the floor.
Both sides taking quality swings. Greeley took a quality swing there. Stronzoli took one for her side as well. Two fairly evenly matched teams, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, this is a high-level match being played here in the first set. Ping pong back and forth. Felix! Denied by Calais Squared.
Not a great swing on the overpass, but a terrific block by, as you say, Calais Squared. Calais Greeley, Calais Adolfo.
And we're tied at 16. Mendoza to serve. The pass by Drolson. Low, high set goes to Stronzoli, hits it into the net, and Hawaii surges in front for the moment. Yeah. Yeah, we mentioned in the pregame about the electricity that fills the San Sheriff Center when these two teams take the floor against one another. They played at least once every season since 1974. And right now this crowd, which appears to be a pretty good one, is lively as the ace by Mendoza puts Hawaii up two in the first. Series record is sponsored by Aston Hotels and Resorts. They've played a lot, again, at least once every season since 1974. The last meeting last year, September 7th, and Hawaii winning by way of a sweep.
By the way, UCLA's played in nothing but sweeps this year. They've been swept twice, and they won three times 3-0.
Mendoza with the serve out of the timeout. Step out, goes to Felix, off the block. Ginger Long keeps it alive. Saved by Higgins. Opportunity for the Bruins. Seko's back row, a low off the block. Diving save, Manuolegao. Higgins the second touch, and Greeley returns it. Step out, Felix puts it down. Good effort by the Rainbow Wahine on that.
Wow. First, a low just rips one off the block. Somehow or another, Manuolegao brings that back up. And look at Felix on the step out maneuver on the right side. Straight down, a la Carstolo.
Felix, a Pac-12 all-freshman team member last season. And it's Stronzali back to serve. Pass Manuolegao. Higgins tight to the net. Greeley. Off speed that finds the end line. The freshman in perhaps her toughest match of her UH career. Stepping it up here early, Chris.
Only one problem. That last play at the net. Taylor Higgins was a back row player. And she attacked the ball. Point goes to UCLA.
Oh, they changed
fans
it up.
Fans don't like it, but it was a correct call by Wayne Lee.
They changed it up, and Dave Shoji was quickly up off the bench to argue the call, but obviously to no avail. Greeley trying to get it back. Stronzali there. Back row goes to low against a solo block dug up by Mendoza. Higgins high to the back row. Manuolegao. Bump set goes to low for UCLA. Right there to stick it is Mendoza. Back row set, Manuolegao did not get it above the tape.
Mendoza, nice dig off Carcelo's back row attack, but you notice how tough Carcelo is? She hits from anywhere.
Dave Shoji signals for a timeout.
OC Sports, presented on Oceanic Time Warner Cable, is sponsored by Bank of Hawaii and Kaiser Permanente.
So it went from a Greeley kill moments ago for the Rainbow Wahine to a point for UCLA. Explain this, Chris.
Taylor Higgins goes up and has a little joust there. She's a back row player and therefore is considered an attacker when it touches a UCLA blocker's hands. And so that's why, and then Mike Seeley came up and told Wayne Lee, hey, Wayne, I think Taylor Higgins was back row. He looks over and sees Taylor Higgins rotate to the front, and he calls the point, rightfully so, for UCLA.
UCLA serving out of the timeout, so we're knotted up again. Here's Bushler off the block. There's Mendoza. Higgins has to get her back. She does. And it's two-handed over by Manuolegao. Left side, here's Bushler again against a solo block net violation called against Higgins.
Boy, Bushler really brings a lot of heat in the outside. That's her second kill of the night. No errors. Just a solid, steady player there on the outside. Was not penciled in to be a starter to start the year. There's actually two other starters that are sidelined with injuries. She's just won a spot and really has been playing well.
Block was up late. Greeley took advantage. We're tied at 20. Yeah, UCLA and Hawaii, a lot of parallels here early on. I mean, inconsistent play. You mentioned all sweeps for the Bruins coming into this. Four sweep wins, two sweep losses, but also missing some key injured players on both sides.
Hawaii obviously missing Nikki Taylor.
Bushler. Dug up back over the net by Manuolegao. Consani goes outside to Bushler again over the double block. Mendoza there. Kendra Kelshu just rotated in. The dink by Manuolegao is returned, and now Hawaii with the advantage. The middle set, though, was not there. Kelsch's call for the miss hit. Dave Shoji not happy about that last sequence, obviously. So Kelsch back out. Taylor Higgins back in. Served by Consani. Pass Greeley. Higgins goes step out. Adolfo. Put it right down the seam.
Oh, the captain's got it going tonight. He has got it going tonight. Struggled the last few outings. But tonight, finding the seams. Quick move to the outside. Taking off of one leg.
Ryan and Lisa both saying in the pregame, Adolfo needed to play well. Bushler dug up by Anderson. The pass tight to the net. Here's Lowe off the block, and it falls down on the Hawaii side of the net. You had an interesting comparison for Karsta Lowe. You compared her to a former University of Hawaii men's star, Yuval Cotts.
Yes, I thought she played a lot. Like when I watched that Illinois match, she just dominated. 29 kills against the number 9 team in the country. She just put on a show, and she continues to do it night in and night out. She's got the nozzle shot. She got a wide fan of attack, lots of tools, and hits with power.
And wins that duel at the net. UCLA up 2 and closing in on this first set. Dave Shoji's going to signal for another timeout. So the Bruins up 23-21 here in the opening stanza. Go inside the numbers presented by Levitt, Yamani, and Soldner. 6.76. That is the kills per set for UCLA's Karsta Lowe. That's tops in the nation. If you're wondering, the NCAA record in the 25-point rally scoring era, 6.23 by Taylor Henderson of Tulsa. You hear the ovation. For the first time this season, Nikki Taylor is in the match for the Rainbow Wahine, making her sophomore season debut in the back row.
She may get a D set out of the back row right away. We'll see.
Higgins goes middle to McGill. Fourth kill for Olivia. And Hawaii gets the point. And quickly, Nikki Taylor draws the ovation, plays for that sequence, and is taken out, replaced by Megan Huff.
And here's what Dave Shoji told me. He said, we don't want her playing in the front row quite yet. We don't want to risk that elbow getting hurt again, especially on a Karsta Lowe attack. And I can see why now, don't you?
Yeah, well, that's how she sustained the elbow injury, was during a block in the offseason, so hasn't quite worked to that point yet in practice. Big miss on the serve by Taylor Higgins. And UCLA with the aloha ball here in the first set. Manole Val trying to extend things.
This match turning out to be everything it was predicted to be. Close, hard fought, great rallies.
How important is this serve here? And that's how the opening set ends. UCLA wins 25-23 on a service error by Manuel Leval. Still plenty of volleyball to be played here at the Stan Sheriff Center. The crowd is buzzing, but the Rainbow Wahine will have to play from behind.
OC Sports, presented on Oceanic Time Warner Cable, is sponsored by Straub and Hawaii Honda Dealers.
Welcome back. UCLA winning the first set, 25-23. Let's take a look at tonight's Jack Fact. And the Jack Fact is, a home away from home, UCLA will play 4 home matches on the campus of Pepperdine this season. UCLA's home courts, Pauley Pavilion, Wooden Center, were damaged by a water main break back on July 29th. It was a Sunset Boulevard water main break, caused flooding damage to those two venues. And so it's been a scramble schedule-wise for UCLA.
Luckily, their practice court was not damaged in the Wooden Center, but the main Wooden Center court was damaged. Both those courts are being fixed now. And Mike Seale also managed to take his USC match, which was to be played at home early on. Does have to play that at Pepperdine. He swapped that out, and he's going to get to host the Trojans late in the season. That'll be a big matchup, obviously.
Speaking of big, as you take a look at the head coaches, Mike Seeley and Dave Shoji, the UCLA block, which we advertised as being big, 4 total team blocks compared to 2 in that first set. It will be Hawaii to serve first here in the second stanza. Mendoza slaps it over. The pass by Formico. Middle set, Nightingale. Right there is Higgins. So a bump set by Mendoza. Too tight to the net. Easy pickings for Carstolo. AVCA honorable mention, all Pac-12 first teamer last season. And would you believe she began her UCLA career as a walk-on? Was under-recruited out of La Costa Canyon High School. Here's Long. That's dug up by Lowe. Lowe gets the set. And again, it's like clockwork.
And you wonder how she could be under-recruited.
Unbelievable. She was a volleyball and tennis player in the early part of her high school career. Decided to pick one. She picked volleyball. And again, because of being under-recruited, walked on at UCLA. It took about half a season for her to earn a full ride. And now, perhaps the best player in the nation. Here's Greeley, blocked by Lowe. Kept alive by Long. Long gets the set on the opposite side, and she's roofed. That time it was Claire Felix and Olga Stronzali.
6-6 and 6-1 against them. Again, a big Bruin block. Got to hit those high hands. Can't be lobbing it tight on the net.
And this second set starting in stark contrast to what we saw in the opening set when Hawaii got up to the early lead, but a good set in the middle to Kalei Adolfo.
Four kills and six tries. Kalei hitting 667 so far. Nice start for Kalei Adolfo.
UCLA hit 265 as a team in the first set compared to 189 for Hawaii. Here's Lowe, cross court, and puts it down. For Carstolo, that's kill number 7 on 12 swings, hitting up near 600.
They've showed you up off the bench, claiming that there's two double hits in the last couple of sets by UCLA, and he wants Wayne Lee to call the game just a little bit tighter.
Outserved by Lowe. Again, Lowe tops in the nation in kills per set. Also leads UCLA's team in hitting percentage and service aces. She does a little bit of everything.
How about hitting 414 as an outside hitter? That's unheard of. That's a middle blocker kind of a stat.
Step out goes to Felix. The dink slapped up by Manuolivau. Two-handed over by Greeley. Consani goes step out to Felix off the block. One hand saved by Kahakai. Manuolivau centers it. Greeley sends it over. Now Lowe from the back row. Didn't get all of it. Mendoza dug it up. Manuolivau had to take something off. Chance now for the Bruins. They go to Stronzali. But Kalei Adolfo says you shall not pass.
Kalei Adolfo, when she starts roaming at the net, there's not many better blockers than her in the country. She goes up, she gets over, she's got great hands, good footwork, and the big smile celebration afterwards.
Greeley with the serve for Hawaii, trying to even things up. Overpass, and Adolfo wins the duel. And we're knotted up here in the second set.
Consani goes up against Adolfo again. Usually it's the last shove that wins that match, wins that battle. Not necessarily the stronger, bigger player all the time.
Pass by Drolson. They go back row to Lowe. Mendoza dug it up over the net, but wide for a UCLA point and another kill for Lowe. And did you see how far she drifted on that?
Yeah, exactly. And broken plays become almost set plays for UCLA because they could throw it up to Carstolo when they get in trouble, and she'll come through. Eight kills already.
Zero hitting errors. Stronzali with the serve. Pass Kahakai, a good one. Step out, Adolfo, cross court and in. She's got it working.
Her fifth kill with no errors so far. That time she had a good, well-formed block, and she just went over. Nice cross-court shot.
She's hitting 714. Five kills, no errors on seven attempts, and then throw three blocks in there for good measure. Claire Marie Anderson now with the serve. Punahou serve to Punahou passer. It was an overpass and ended on a Punahou alum kill. Yet Anderson for Punahou. The overpass by Punahou alum Rachel Inouye and Manuolivau to finish.
Must have seemed like an inter-squad scrimmage. Deja vu all over again.
And Hawaii up a point. Make it a tie.
How about this crowd tonight? This looks like this place holds 10,300. And I'll bet there's, what are you going to guess, 85 tonight? Is that too generous?
I would not put that completely past you there. I think we're definitely bumping up into the eight range,
exactly.
On the eye test. But we'll see the official numbers later on in the evening. There's an overpass, and Riley Bushler is able to smack it down.
Bushler picks up kill number three. No errors.
UCLA back on top. Taylor Formico with the serve. Greeley, the pass, left side. Manolibao against a solo block, and she gobbles that one up.
Give credit to McGill and Higgins that time. They did a nice decoy in the middle to give Manolibao the one-on-one attack on the outside.
And this is where Hawaii can perhaps get something going. If some tough serves come off of the palm of Taylor Higgins and Taimana Olevao, Bushler missing the court wide, point Hawaii.
Oh, and Bushler put up a great pass. Higgins just ripped her serve. Bushler put up almost a perfect pass and just missed on the outside, trying to get the outside pinkies of the blocker.
Good serve. Inoue had a little trouble on the pass, centered and low. Flat-footed will send it over. Chance for Hawaii. Right side. Ginger Long roofed. Bushler got up and got most of that one. Already the fifth tie of this second set.
Bushler's mom, also a great player at the University of Arizona, was a setter. Played at MiraCosta.
Yeah, was an All-American in Arizona. Manolevao, fingertips and down. Inoue couldn't quite get turned on it. Hawaii back up front.
This is a smart play going to high hands over the 6-3 Zoe Nightingale. That's how you get it done against those big blocks.
Fifth kill for Manolevao. She's hitting 300. Here's the serve. Good pass by Formico. Bump set low. And there is, right now, no stopping Karsta Lowe from anywhere on the floor. You've used the term Terminator, Chris, to describe several hitters, but Karsta Lowe might be the most terminating Terminator we've seen.
Yeah, and I've been doing this a long time. She is among the best ever. Like I said, Yuval Kotz-like.
Olivia McGill, not too shabby herself. And that vaults Hawaii ahead.
Boy, Olivia keeps driving hard in the middle, trying to get more sets. And when she gets a good pass goes up there, she wants the ball no matter how many blockers are up.
10 serving 9. Mendoza sends it down the line. Diving bump set that time by Consani. So a chance for Hawaii. Here's Manolevao from the back row, blocked and roofed. It was Nightingale up in the middle who got most of that one.
One of Nightingale's best blocking nights was back in 2011 when they won the national championship. She had 8 kills, 11 blocks in the final against Illinois. What a night that must have been for her.
Right side, here's Long the dink. Perfectly timed, perfectly placed. Hawaii back on top. We are going seesaw-like here in the second set.
Ginger Long does a nice job of identifying the defense is playing back on her, so she drops it in short.
Kahakai with the serve. Step out. Nope, it goes to low on the right side, dug up by Kahakai. Here's Manolevao from the back row. The off-speeder bumped up by Stronzoli. She'll get the set. She pulls the string, punched up in the air by Adolfo. Greeley from the 3-meter. Here's low. Off the block. Kahakai two-hands it. Advantage Hawaii. Manolevao took something off. Stronzoli there. Good rally here. Middle set to Felix, dug up by Mendoza. Greeley, can she finish it? No. Into the twine it goes. Point UCLA.
Well, I got to credit the Bruins for persevering on that long rally. Just kept keeping the ball in play. Stronsley kept her shots in play.
Karsta Lowe to serve. Kahakai, perfect pass. Greeley from the outside. And a net violation called against the Bruins. So give the point to the Rainbow Wahine.
Time goes on. Consani.
Here's Here's Greeley. Had the heavily taped left ankle last night. Not heavily taped here tonight. Looks like she's feeling better. Here's Lowe. Mendoza digs it up back over the net. The pass, though, tight to the net. And Stronzali goes off the block and out. Higgins tried to challenge her. But when you have those two lefties, how does that change the blocking approach when it's a left-handed hitter?
It changes everything because you're so used to seeing right-handed players. Rarely do run into one left-hander, let alone two. Luckily for Hawaii, they've got James Ka as a volunteer assistant this year, and he's a lefty.
Step out to Adolfo, couldn't get all of it. Kahakai, back set to Manoelevao. Just missed that deep corner. And the Bruins on top, 13-12.
Kahakai with a gutsy back set there to Manoelevao.
Fourth lead change here in this second set. High toss from Stronzali. Pass Mendoza, Higgins goes outside, Manoelevao came soaring in. As if she rappelled from the ceiling, and she was able to put the smack down on that one.
Give some credit to Kalea Dolfo. She draws a lot of attention in the middle. They commit on her and gives Manoelevao one-on-one, and she just rips it down the line right in Carson Lowe's lap.
Did they used to call that a six-pack back in the day?
Yeah.
Six-pack on the team from the Pac-12.
Yeah.
Here's Buschler off the block and out.
Buschler's playing so well, and she was not penciled to start. You know, the two other people were penciled to start. Jessica Namo and Haley Lawless were both penciled in on the outside to start, and they did not recover from offseason injuries, I guess. They're not suited up or going to play this weekend. And here comes Buschler, and she's just doing a terrific job.
Manoelevao sends it long. Point UCLA, no. Now the late call from the line judge. There was a touch. So give the point to Hawaii and give the kill to Manoelevao.
With her high hand attacker, she's going off the middle blocker that time. Hard to tell on that. The ball's traveling so fast, but I'm sure that a pinky was bent back.
Smoking serve by Higgins. Bump set goes outside. Buschler turned back.
Find the perfect gift for every occasion at Big Island Candies. Visit them in Hilo at Ala Moana Center or click on BigIslandCandies.com to view their entire collection and place your order today.
Hey, UH fans, select your exact seat locations when purchasing individual game tickets at HawaiiAthletics.com. Click on the tickets button to print your tickets. Avoid the lines by going online. Hawaii up 15-14. Taylor Higgins serving out of the timeout here in set two. Just missing the end line was that Higgins serve. Dave Shoji is looking at the officials.
I didn't miss by much, I'll tell you that. Did not miss by much. We'll take a look at it here, see if we can slow it down.
Ooh. That's very close. Meanwhile, the momentum change as Julie Consani serves up the ace for UCLA and the Bruins go on top. And it just goes to show how those little millimeters can make a difference.
Volleyball is such a game of runs and momentum.
16 serving 15, Consani to serve. Pass Manoelevao. High and away, long over the top of the block. Dug up by Inouye. Here's Lowe. Stuffs it through the block. Return. Ping pong back and forth. Hawaii has it. Bump set goes right side. Manoelevao. That's dug up by Consani. And it'll be a mishit called against Buschler, who had to take on the setting responsibilities because of the Consani dig.
That was Mike Seely not happy with that, but I'll tell you, I think the score on close calls like that and double hits is about 3-1 in favor of UCLA. They've gotten three breaks, Hawaii's got one.
Manoelevao, stiff pass by Formico. Here's Lowe. Blocked and root! Olivia McGill up next to Ginger Long.
You know, we're talking about a scouting reporter, Mike Seely, knowing what Olivia McGill's doing. She's watched for the last 2 years. Well, McGill's watched Lowe for the last 2 years as well, so you got to think that she's got some advantage.
It can happen. The first hitting error by Karsta Lowe. Here she is again. That time went through the block and down.
You may stop her once, but you're not going to stop her too many times in a row, that's for sure.
Yeah, the law of probabilities are very much in Lowe's favor.
Yeah, that was her first mistake of the night in that last attack. 10 kills, one error, still hitting 409, right around her season average.
Just ridiculous numbers. Middle set, McGill. Oh, she had to levitate for a moment and was able to put it down.
It's a good thing it was a missed set, a missed time, because Zoe Nightingale was right there to stuff her. She missed it, slapped it down. I think that ball had backspin on it.
Middle set goes to Nightingale. Right back at you go the Bruins. We got ourselves a match tonight. So competitive in terms of just how even these squads appear to be.
Yeah. Nightingale, only her third set of the night.
The 15th tie of this second set. Middle set to Adolfo. Caught it a little fat. Chance for the Bruins. Here's Lowe. Good touch up front by that Hawaii block. Now Greeley. Pass Lowe and to the floor.
The freshman against the senior. What a matchup. Kalei Greeley going up eyeball to eyeball against Karsten Lowe and just drills it to the floor. Greeley now with 7 kills.
Hitting 250. Middle goes to Felix off of one leg. Claire Felix, who's listed on the roster as an outside hitter but playing the middle position, perhaps a little bit in part due to the injuries here in the early season for UCLA, but at 6'6", not a hard call, I guess.
Could have also been a misprint.
And Lowe, what happened there? She hit it below the net.
That was shocking, to say the least.
Kendra Kelsch back in now, replacing Taylor Higgins for the moment, as Kalei Greeley, very deliberate behind that service line, gets the whistle, takes a few bounces, needs the ball for a moment, and then floats it over. Tough serve. Set up, though, goes to Stronzoli, dug up by Greeley. Kelsch, high and away, Manuele Val blocked and roofed.
Kelsch put up a nice set that time to Manuele Val. Just the block was out there waiting for it, camped out.
And the long arms of 6'6" Claire Felix. We're tied again.
Felix bringing a lot of energy to the floor right now for the Bruins. Said her biggest thrill was when she signed her letter of intent with UCLA.
Felix on the overpass, but Mendoza kept it alive, chased down by Kahakai. Free chance for the Bruins. Where do they go? High and away, Buschler, dug up by Manuele Val. Kahakai will bump set Manuele Val. Off the block and out. Point for Rando Wahine.
That was a huge point, and what a bump set from Savannah Kahakai. Not an easy ball to set. It was spinning hard from the dig. She took the spin off it somehow, and Ole Val goes for the small blocker, the 5'11 blocker, Consani, and gets the kill. Eighth of the night.
And here is Claire Marie Anderson to serve. Pass by Formico. Step out, Felix. Wow, that was a hammer.
Oh, and Felix gets the ball set where she wants it, in her wheelhouse. She's almost unstoppable. She just goes down the line easily.
6'6" and athletic. Yes. I think that's the part that's awe-inspiring.
Good footwork, nice arm swing. She's got it all.
Here's Manuele Val. Denied access by Zoe Nightingale. Nightingale is a block machine. Entered the match tied for first on the team with 17 rejections. Hawaii trailing by a point. Take a look at the Mid-Pac Petroleum leaderboard. All-time Division I women's volleyball victories. UCLA, with that win last night over San Francisco, reached the 1,200th victory in the women's volleyball program's history. Hawaii in sixth position at 1133.
Those are the pioneers, those programs that started way back in the mid-70s.
Watch out, watch out.
UCLA with the advantage out of the timeout. Greeley passes the serve. Manole Val caught it fat. Was there a touch? No touch. Point Bruins. And just like in the first set, UCLA up 23-21. Timeout taken by Dave Shoji. Let's check out how it works, presented by Central Pacific Bank. Chris.
Let's take a look at the theory of hitting high hands, which Manu Olival is getting pretty good at. She had two big blockers on her on that right side. She goes up and hits high hands and gets the kill. Easier to see from this angle. Watch how she goes for the high hands and not hit it low across there. Hits it high, catches the hands right there of Zoe Nightingale, and gets yet another kill. And that's how it works when you run up against a big team and you got to hit the high hands.
Nikki Taylor back into the match for Hawaii. Was in for a quick rotation in that first stanza, so she's out there now in the back row. UCLA brings in Izzy Carmona, 6'3 sophomore. Spent her freshman season at Florida State. But UCLA up a deuce.
Carmona in for Consani, the setter.
Here's Manole Val, dug up on one knee by Formico. It's going to be Bushler from off the net. Right there's Mendoza. Higgins, jump set. Manole Val blocked. She keeps it alive herself. Higgins touches it over and finds the Terraflex.
I thought for sure she was going to back set to Nikki Taylor out of the back row. Instead, she called her own number, and it worked. I think Hawaii has run out of substitutions. Nikki Taylor is forced to go to the front row.
This is something that Dave Shoji was saying he would try to avoid. Here's Bushler off the block and down. Point for UCLA. 24-22. So a tough decision here for Dave Shoji, but again forced a little bit by the substitution limit.
He was hoping they'd run to... Taylor would still be in the back row and they'd score all their points there with serving.
And a service error by Kamsani. Hawaii within one. And Manuole Val, who this weekend has been the Rainbow Wahine's hottest server with six service aces last night. Served it into the net to end game one. And sends it long to end game two. UCLA wins 25-23 for the second straight set. And if the Rainbow Wahine are to win tonight, they're going to have to win in five. 0-2 was able to push it to five. What's the difference between UCLA and Oregon, you think?
That girl right there, Carson Lowe. I mean, with all due respect to Oregon and Brenner, she was a great player, but she couldn't take over a game like Karsten Lowe can take over a game.
Lowe with 10 kills, hitting 391. It is Stronzoli to serve to open this third set. Greeley sends it to the back row. Bruins go to Bushler on the outside. Greeley the dig. Higgins, where does she go? High and away. Manuole Val with a little extra sting on it that time.
And Calandolfo drew a lot of attention as a decoy in the middle that time, giving Manuole Val a split block.
So Hawaii out the gate first here in the third set. Mendoza, who has Hawaii's only service ace thus far. Low, dug up by Mendoza. Bump set Higgins to Greeley from the back row against a single blocker. Makes it count.
Mendoza once again, Hawaii's got 36 digs. Guess what? Mendoza's got 13 of them. Here she is once again, young lady from Santa Barbara, the senior associate captain.
Tough serve by Mendoza. One-footed hit by Felix, dug up by Greeley. Greeley from way off the net hits it into the twine.
I like the way she took a swing at that. I think more players on those broken plays ought to be attacking that ball more rather than bumping it over or putting it over with a two-handed set. So I like the way Greeley is aggressive that way.
Now Taylor Formico. Kahakai the pass, middle set. McGill rising amongst the clouds that time. And she just sort of hangs up there for a split second or two.
Oh, yeah. She can touch 10-6. She can hang a long time. She's got those long arms as well. Picks up kill number 7.
So 3 serving 1. Here's Higgins, the jump serve. Just crawls over the net. Now Bushler against the double block. There's Mendoza. Higgins sets up Manu Olivao through the block, and a net violation called against UCLA. Hawaii gets the point. They're up 4-1.
Joy Nightingale into the net there, but how about Mendoza again? And how about the way that serve did a little dance on the cable?
Here's Higgins again. Good pass by Formico. Step out, Nightingale blocked. Saved by Inouye. Bushler. Net violation called against Hawaii. And they're going to get Megan Huff on this one. So the freshman getting tangled up in the twine, and it's going to be a UCLA point. By the way, the tickets issued tonight, 82-23 through the turnstile, up near 7,000 here at the Stan Sheriff Center. Middle set, McGill blocked, kept alive by Huff, and a miss hit by Higgins. Little indecision there as to where she was going to go. Everyone all bunched together.
Communication breakdown. And you'll see that happen early in the season. These players not played together all that much.
McGill, that's set a little low, and she still is able to find a way to make it work. And that's in part because of her tremendous jumping ability. She can take an extra second or two to make a decision.
She goes up there, she hovers, she looks, she tips.
Manu Olivao took a little something off of that one. Right side, here's Bushler. Forget about it.
Straight down block that was by Kalei Greeley, going up against another terrific freshman in Riley Bushler.
Help on the seat, Kalei.
Manu Olivao finds the end line. Ace for Hawaii. Mike Seeley, Stein Metzger, both off the bench. They couldn't believe the call right in front of where they're sitting. They said it missed by a couple of inches. But it's a point for Hawaii. 7 serving 3. The pass by Formico. Middle set, Nightingale off of the dome of McGill and into the seats. Let's take a look at this last service ace. In or out?
Tough to really tell. Oh, McGill takes it right off the forehead. Eyes still watering.
7 serving 4. Here's Greeley to pass. McGill had to dink it right there, though. Is Kansani. Low.
You know, if McGill doesn't get with the kill, then she comes up on the McGill block. Either way, she's happy Hawaii got the point, I'll tell you that. And she is so happy to be here. I'm so glad that she transferred over and is playing in this marvelous place with so many people who appreciate her skills night in and night out.
The human wall at the net, Olivia McGill. Hawaii up 8-4. Middle set, Nightingale. Right there is Higgins. It's Anderson bump setting Manu Olivao from the back row against a triple block. But UCLA keeps it alive. Now Tranzali. Left side, Greeley blocked and roofed. And again, going up against Karsta Lowe over there on that outside antenna.
Lowe at 6-4. Zoe Nightingale at 6-3. That's a big block in anybody's ballpark. I'm telling you, that's a tough play.
Now Zoe Nightingale to serve. Pop straight up in the air by Manu Olivao. Mendoza bump sets Manu Olivao from the back row. Low, off the touch by Felix. Couldn't control it, so a point for Hawaii. Give the kill to Manu Olivao, her 11th of the match. Closing in on a double-double as well, has 8 digs. Here's Kahakai. Stronzoli sends it straight up. Bump set goes to Stronzoli from off the net. She's able to still put some heat on it.
Big swing. Stronzoli in her first American debut in the first weekend makes all tournament. Number 2 in kills per set now.
Here's Lowe. Step out, Adolfo, a little tight to the net. Saved off the net by Kahakai. Chance now for the Bruins. Step out, Felix. Down the line and in. So a point for UCLA. It is 7-9. And scary when you think about the Bruins. Some of the injuries here in the early season. A team that was preseason picked to finish 8th in the Pac-12, but now one of 7 Pac-12 teams in the national rankings. Scary to think how good they can be as the season goes on. Felix, low set, was still able to get it through Adolfo. And the Bruins within a point here, Chris.
Yeah, you got to give Consani a lot of credit here. She's the transfer from, there she is right there, the transfer from Cal State Fullerton. 3 seasons with Cal State Fullerton. Comes in and is playing with players she's never played with before.
Greeley.
And she's connecting pretty well with the middles.
Formico, the dig, here's Lowe from the back row. Mendoza off the ricochet, touched over on the second hit by Higgins. Lowe again from the back row. Past Adolfo and down.
Lowe, kill number 11.
We're tied up at 9, and on that cue, Dave Shoji gives the call to Nikki Taylor to enter the match. So she has played in each set thus far, albeit briefly. A 4-0 run here for the Bruins. Left side, Greeley, off the touch, is able to get the point back to Hawaii. So yet to see a set go in the direction of Nikki Taylor.
And I wonder if Taylor Higgins has got directions to lay off Nikki for a while, let her get her feet wet a little bit, and not go to her unless absolutely necessary. Those might be her instructions.
10-9, Greeley. Stiff pass there. Step out Felix off the block, but a net violation against Hawaii. They're going to give that one to Kale Adolfo. It was either Adolfo or Manuole Val.
Right there with her forearm catches a little bit of cable.
Jump serve, Stronzoli sends it deep and long. So out serve, point Hawaii, and McGill coming in for Adolfo. But you have Nikki Taylor, the Kaiser High School graduate, 6'3 sophomore, out there on the floor, making her debut tonight. First team all Big West selection last season, was second on the team behind Emily Hartong in kills per set. Bushler, another net violation called against Hawaii. This time it's Taylor Higgins.
Dave Shoji not happy there. He doesn't like to give those freebies away, especially when there's been a dig on the play.
11 serving 11, and number 11, Taylor Formico with the serve. McGill over the top of the block, one hand save low, tight to the net. McGill smothers that one.
I think smother is a perfect word for that, because that ball never had a chance to go over. Olivia just reached over and put it right back down. Watch how far over she gets on this play. Reaches over without touching that and just pushed it straight down.
That was a slam dunk right there. Higgins into the twine. So that bugaboo in the form of service errors that haunted Hawaii the opening weekend kind of rearing its ugly head tonight, Chris.
Yeah, actually, it's not the volume of missed serves, it's the timing of them.
Here's Megan Huff against the solo block. Wasn't the cleanest of contacts, but Huff off the outside of the hand able to make it count.
She had a tough set with which to work that time, and it was tight against Karsten Lowe, who was an excellent blocker.
That is Huff's 10th kill of the season. Now Manuole Val, again, taking something off, pass tight to the net, and it's going to be a free opportunity for Hawaii. Higgins, where does she go? Middle set, McGill. Dug up by Consani. Here's Bushler, pushes it, blocked, rattled around, sent over the net, and out! The Bruins nearly had a scramble point there, but it just went beyond the end line, point for Hawaii.
I think the air conditioning blew that one out. Hawaii got very lucky there.
One of the tunnelway doors must have been left open. 14 serving 12. Inouye with a perfect pass. Here's Lowe over the top of that formidable block by Hawaii. McGill and Huff, that's no joke. She went over the top.
6-3 and 6-3 goes over both of them. Can you believe it? She's the real deal, don't you think?
Yeah, I'm starting to believe that. There's no doubt. Karsten Lowe now with 11 kills, hitting .333.
If your father were here, after 30 years of calling with him, calling games, I guarantee he would say, I haven't seen anybody like that before.
Nightingale with the roof there in the middle of McGill, and we're tied at 14.
Nightingale, such a solid block, reaches over, takes that cut back away. Olivia loves to hit that cutback shot.
Fifth tie of this third set. It has been neck and neck the entire match. Here's Greeley against the double block. The save there by Drolson. Low. Karsta low. And she gets it rolling. Virtually unstoppable. UCLA first to 15. Timeout on the floor. And Hawaii trying to stay alive against the Bruins. Time now for the Fujitsu air conditioning cool play of the match. Karsta Lowe may very well be the best player in college volleyball, but on this moment, earlier in the match, Taimano Levau was able to give her some chin music.
That was a great swing by Ty down the line. Karsta normally digs those, but not that time.
11 kills for Mono Levau, but Hawaii trailing 15-14. Here's Greeley off the top of the block. Bruins go to Stronzoli, and she's turned back. Megan Huff and Olivia McGill.
Stronzoli was the number two scorer in the Division I league in Greece, so she can play at the highest level.
Yeah, won three national school championships in Greece. Middlesex goes to Nightingale, and she says goodnight. 16-15, UCLA back on top. Hawaii led by as many as four here in this third set.
Nightingale with her fourth kill, hitting 571, yet to make an error, Miss Zoe.
Good pass by Mano Levau. Here's Huff. Oh, had to readjust her approach. So the Bruins go to Karsta Lowe, dug up by Higgins. Mano Levau, she had to hesitate. And then just hit it, soaring beyond the end line.
Pretty good set by Huff, too, in the middle there. The ball was spinning very hard off the dig, and most people would take it up and bump it up there, but not Huff. She brought out her hands and put up a nice ball.
This is a 5-1 run here for UCLA. Higgins, Hawaii, needs it. Greeley delivers it. How steady of a force has she been for Hawaii as just a freshman?
Rock solid, makes good shot selection, sees the line open, goes down the line, hits for the open part of the court. I like the way she swings on broken plays as well. That's my favorite part about her game.
Here is the serve by Nikki Taylor. Almost an ace. Free chance, though, for Hawaii. Pushed over on the second touch by Higgins. Punched back over. Taylor there for Hawaii. Here's Greeley. In! Hits the end line. Disbelief over the ruling. That's 11 kills for Greeley. She and Manuole Vau both on that number, and Hawaii has tied it. Taylor the serve. Middle set. Felix sends it long. Was there a touch? No touch up front. Hawaii back on top. 18-17 here in the third.
A rare error from Felix.
And a timeout taken by Mike Seeley. Hawaii trying to hang in there. Back here at the Stan Sheriff Center, Hawaii down 0-2 in the match, up a point here in set number three. The Rainbow Wahine very well could have won one, if not both, of those first two sets. Nikki Taylor making her sophomore season debut tonight, back behind the service line. Hawaii trying to stay alive here against this Pac-12 opponent and rival UCLA. Karsta Lowe!
And Greeley, almost in a state of disbelief that she just blocked the best player in the country right there.
Solo style.
Straight down.
And Taylor with the service error.
So again, it's not so much the service error, it's the timing of the errors. Just when Hawaii's getting a little momentum, it goes into the net. Or the two set points that went long and into the net.
And now you have low, flat-footed serve. Here is Nikki Taylor. First swing of the season. That's dug up. Now low from the back row off the block and down. Point UCLA, and we draw even again.
Taylor, her nice first swing. I like that first swing. Had a lot of heat on it. Hit it down the line. Only to be answered by Karsta Lowe's back row attack.
UCLA, one of the programs that recruited Nikki Taylor out of high school. Here she is again. Low, leans in, just trickles it over the top of the net. Higgins, middle set to Adolfo, the dink. Advantage Bruins. Felix on the step out over the block. Dug up by Taylor to the net. Joust at the net. And Taylor Higgins wins it.
I told you it's not always the biggest or strongest that wins the joust. It's the last push.
5-9 beats 6-6.
Is this David and Goliath or what? You tell me. Malcolm Gladwell wrote a great book on that, David versus Goliath.
Step out Felix off the block. Mendoza couldn't apply the spatula. And we're tied again. I mean, this is how this match has gone all night long. It has been neck and neck, back and forth, a plethora of ties throughout each of the first three sets.
There's a beauty of this classic rivalry as well. It always draws out the best in the players, draws out the best in the crowd.
Very tough serve from Stronzoli. Handled by Greeley. Outside, Manolevao against the double block. Stronzoli punches it up in the air. Bump set goes to Buschler. Pretty good set, and Buschler finds the deep corner. Past the diving Mendoza. Almost looked like some communication issues on that second bump set, but it wound up being a pretty good setup.
I think Lowe got it, but you're right. It was communication issues, but they got up a good set.
UCLA by a point. And a look at the UCLA bench. We talk about the Hawaii connections on the coaching staff. Head coach Mike Seeley, of course, spent four seasons as an associate head coach with Dave Shoji at the University of Hawaii. Stein Metzger, a Punahou alum, former UCLA setter, won the national championship. Remember that national title game against Hawaii in 1996. And you also have Kaylee Thurlby, former Rainbow Wahine, now the director of operations for UCLA.
A lot of Hawaii connections. There's Stein right there, also played in the Olympics. In beach volleyball?
Yeah. In fact, his partner for a while in beach volleyball was Kevin Wong, the brother of Hawaii associate Scott Wong.
More connections.
There you go. I'll never forgive Stein Metzger for breaking our hearts, though, in 96. Hawaii up 2-1 in that national final. An incredible player, Stronzoli. With the serve, pass Mendoza, Manolevao over the block. Great effort by the Bruins. I mean, they went in mass after that loose ball, but Hawaii gets the point.
And Taylor Formico almost got that. Taylor Formico, what a story by her. Played for Santa Barbara to begin with and sat out last year. When she was at Santa Barbara, she was led the NCAA in digs for the year, and then all of a sudden leaves and ends up at UCLA.
How about this for a Hawaii connection? She played at St. Francis High School in Mountain View for former MIL Player of the Year and Stanford Defensive Specialist Leahi Hall. Low over the block, dug up by Taylor, back over the net. They go step out. Felix, the block had not quite come together for Hawaii. And the Bruins on top again.
Well, Felix has been so effective in that step out. 9 kills. Hitting for a good percentage as well, hitting 316. Got 4 blocks.
Izzy Carmona back on the floor, replacing Consani in this rotation.
Carmona, former Florida State player.
Formico to serve. Higgins to Manolevao. Low set, has to dink it over. Advantage Bruins. Buschler from the outside. There's Mendoza. Higgins will go outside. Manolevao again. Oh, that had a lot of heat on it, but Inouye scoops it up. But unintentionally shields Formico from the ball. It falls to the floor.
I'm surprised that Formico is pretty aggressive. I'm surprised she didn't just push Inouye out of the way, like right there. Just give her a little right elbow.
Taylor Higgins down the line. Buschler the pass. They go back row to Low off the top of the tape. Mendoza keeps it alive. Higgins low and away to Manolevao. And that one is roofed again by Zoe Nightingale and company.
Zoe, such a solid blocker. Made all NCAA tournament team back in 2011 when they won. That's how good she is in blocking.
Consani the serve. Higgins, quick middle. McGill blocked. McGill touches it over. Chance for the Bruins. Here's Lowe. cross-court hard angle. And again, as we get to this juncture of each set, UCLA has found itself up a couple of points. They've been first to 23 each set as close as this match has been played.
It's, you could really, you could play three more games that could go three, you know, if UCLA were to win, you could play three more sets and Hawaii could win the next three sets. I mean, it's that, these two teams are that close. It's just some terrific volleyball being played on both sides of the net. Both teams holding each other to very poor kill percentages. Both teams holding about 50 points below their normal kill percentage because of the good defense and the good blocking.
UCLA facing an Aloha Ball situation here out of this timeout. But Ryan Tsuji is upstairs with a VIP tonight. Ryan.
That's right, Kanoa. Well, we know that Hawaii fans are the best. And this young lady right here might be the most loyal, Madeline Lee, who is celebrating her 100th birthday today. Madeline, how long have you been coming to these volleyball games?
Since 1970, I guess.
And what do you enjoy and what brings you here, especially on your 100th birthday?
I like the girls at volleyball. I really like volleyball.
What were some of your more memorable moments? I mean, have you always been, did you used to go to the games when they were at Clum Gym and came on to the arena?
No, I didn't, because my husband had been ill and I had to wait till he passed away before I could do most of anything.
And we heard a story that you could go anywhere to eat dinner tonight for your birthday, but you chose to come here?
Yes.
And why is that?
Well, I don't have much of an appetite at the present time, so.
Well, thank you so much, and happy birthday from all of us at OC Sports. Back to you guys.
Happy birthday, Madeline. Thanks, Ryan. Aloha Ball for UCLA to try to sweep Hawaii. Here's Taylor. That point for Hawaii was tailor-made. Taylor Higgins to Nikki Taylor. And the Rainbow Wahine within one here, still breathing.
I like that, tailor-made, because of the Taylor to Taylor.
And how about the service change here for Dave Shoji? It was going to be Manoʻole Vau serving out or into the net on game point in the first two sets, so he brings Katiana Ponce in.
I think he didn't want to put her in that kind of pressure again.
She gets the serve in. Bruins go high and away. Here's Lowe off the fingertips of the block. There's Mendoza. Higgins out to Taylor. She puts it down. And we're tied at 24. Timeout, UCLA. And how about that? Nikki Taylor back from injury and drawing Hawaii even here in the third.
Couple of cool clutch swings, couple of great sets by Taylor Higgins. This is the last one that goes out there. And Taylor now goes down the line. She goes off the block a little bit as well. She's tooling the block, playing smart as if she hasn't missed a beat from last year.
You can hear the appreciation from the Stan Sheriff Center crowd after those last two kills, not only because of what it means here in the match, but to see Nikki Taylor back out there. So much expectation for her here in her sophomore season after that phenomenal debut a year ago. And we mentioned Taylor made. Taylor Higgins to Nikki Taylor, they have a relationship that goes back to New Valley Intermediate School. And here they are now for the University of Hawaii, trying to stay alive against the Bruins.
Playing in front of such an appreciative crowd as well. But Nikki Taylor, I did not expect to see her in the front row. Dave Shoji told both of us before the match. Well, we might sneak her in the back row a little bit, but I doubt if she's going to play in the front for a couple of weeks.
His concern was because she hasn't done that much blocking in practice yet.
Right. Maybe she's going to just hit and she won't block. She'll just not even put her arms up.
In either case, it appears as though Dave Shoji cutting the cord here on Nikki Taylor. So we'll play some extra volleyball here in the third set. And Katiana Ponce out of Moanalua High School again to serve. Jump floater. A good one. Pass tight to the net. Here's Lowe, blocked, kept alive by Formico. Lowe gets a second crack at it. Blocked again. Middle set goes to Nightingale. Pinballed around and finally falls to the floor. Point for UCLA.
A
Well, Hawaii firm on a couple of occasions against Karstalow on that sequence. But the Bruins still able to get the point. About 7,000 chanting for the home team. Aloha ball again for UCLA. It's Buschler to serve. Mendoza the pass. Higgins, quick middle. McGill has to dink it over. It's rat-a-tatted back and forth. Now Taylor with the swing, and a net violation called against UCLA.
Is Taylor 3 for 3, or is it just me? Not only does she bring the right side attack, she brings the left side attack as well. She's got the Nikki Blast going on, according to the signs. She's re-energized this offense, yeah, obviously.
She's injected some juice here into this match for Hawaii, trying to stay afloat against UCLA. Gianna Guinasso to serve. Pass Formico. They go to low on the opposite side. Adolfo got a piece and then sends a free ball the Bruins' way. It's low again. Oh my goodness, that was a hammer. Karstalow with the crush.
That's otherworldly, I'll tell you. I mean, she just so talented, so strong, has so much range. And they got Greeley on the left, Adolfo in the middle, and Taylor on the right.
Nightingale to serve. Third match point here for UCLA. Adolfo couldn't put it down. Here's Stronzoli off the shoulder of Manoelevao, and she'll bump it over. Free chance for the Bruins. Low from the opposite side. Missed the court wide, but it goes off of the block. And this match is over. UCLA pulls off the sweep against Hawaii. Three sets that really, and you can say this sometimes, it's just cliche, but really three sets that could have gone either way.
Yeah, no question about that. A point here, a point there, a call here, a call there. It was just so close in so many ways. The two teams, you know, hitting for close percentages. A lot of great defense. I thought the night was highlighted by the great digs on both sides. Obviously, both coaches and their staffs had each other scouted well. And that's why this resulted in such a long, even match. Even though it was only three sets, the Bruins now continue their streak of nothing but three-set sweeps this year.
Yep, either they've been swept or they've swept, and right now they're 5-2 on the year. Let's send it over to Scott Rotzi, as Dave showed you.
Hey, thanks a lot, Kanoa. Coach, it seemed like both teams were pretty evenly matched until the last couple of points. Each set, UCLA was able to find a way to win the set.
Yeah, we didn't make the plays down the stretch, and we got to get better at that. Just couldn't make a play. We served out twice, and it's just it's going to make us a better team, but it was real disappointing.
We saw Nikki Taylor for the first time this season. Was that kind of the game plan to bring her in tonight, or was that kind of just a spur-of-the-moment decision?
Well, I had thought about it all day, and I just wanted to play in the back row because I'm not sure about her arm and blocking. That's where she could get hurt again, but we had run out of subs, and if I had her just play back row, we didn't have enough subs. I had to leave her in, and obviously she helps the team.
Will you use her now from now on? Would you leave her and let her play in the front row?
Well, she's cleared to play, so it was just a matter of I didn't really want to use her tonight against Karstalow because Karsta hit so hard. I didn't want to risk it, but we had to play her, and she'll play Sunday for sure.
No match tomorrow. You play on Sunday. Will you guys take the day off, or you practice tomorrow?
Oh no, we're practicing. Trust me, we're going to practice, and we got to get ready for a good San Francisco team. And we can't let our guard down now. We're gonna go hard on Sunday.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach.
All right, bye.
Back to you, Kanoa and Chris.
Thanks a lot, Scott. Bank of Hawaii players of the match, Karstalow, 17 kills, a couple of blocks and 6 digs. Kalei Greeley, quite an effort, 11 kills, 5 blocks, and 5 digs. So Hawaii falls to 0-3 against the Pac-12 here this season. But what's the takeaway here from tonight, Chris?
Well, I think they've got to feel good about going toe-to-toe against three very good Pac-12 teams. I think the Arizona State loss was probably the most disappointing, but Arizona State played really well that night. The Oregon loss, terrific comeback. Tonight, could have gone either way. And I think that playing against these teams in the Pac-12 can only help them in their league play down the stretch. I know Dave shows you really wanting to get one against the 25th ranked team in the country because that'll help his RPI a lot. But you know, if he gets a win against San Francisco on Sunday and San Francisco runs the table in the WCC, then his RPI will go up. But he certainly wants to be careful about what his ranking is as far as the NCAA RPI is concerned so he can get into the NC2As again.
Yeah, people will look at this and they'll say, oh, a sweep loss to UCLA, Hawaii getting clobbered. But in reality, Hawaii just a few missed opportunities away from potentially being able to sweep themselves.
Yeah, very, very close. Could have gone either way. For the fans at home that watched it, I hope you enjoyed all the defense. Sort of for us watching it, being up so close, it was so fun watching Carla Carstalo, as she's just an amazing player who hits the ball so hard, has so much range, and she was worth the price of admission just for the way she plays volleyball.
Yeah, and for Hawaii, again, encouraging to see Nikki Taylor out there. And you heard from Dave Shoji in that interview with Scott Robbs. It sounds like when Hawaii takes on San Francisco on Sunday to close out this tournament, they will be at relative full strength.
Yeah, he's going to reintegrate her back into the lineup, and she'll play. I don't know if she'll start or not, but I'm sure she'll play a lot.
Well, Hawaii falling short here tonight by way of a sweep against UCLA. The Rainbow Wahine falling to 5-3 this young season. But again, some signs of encouragement against the 25th ranked squad in the land. That's it for us. For Chris McLaughlin, I'm Kanoa Leahy. Thanks for watching, everybody. Don't forget about the post-game show. We'll see you next time. Aloha.